Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to Best of One. Today we're actually going to be playing a deck, like a second in the standard challenge on Magic Online. It is a white weenie deck, or as I'm calling it, Lurrus Weenie. This is by Max Capone, and it's not my deck. Again, this one got second in the standard challenge on Magic Online. And I thought it was kind of unique because it's just playing four Lurrus main deck, and it's playing a card, Speaker of the Heavens, which seems powerful, but just doesn't see play. Speaker of the Heavens is just one drop with Vigilance and Lifelink, and you can tap it to make an angel, but only if you have seven more life than your starting life total. So basically, if you're at 27 life, you can tap this, make a 4/4 angel. And you have like some ways to gain life in this deck with like Alcide, Speaker himself, Hushbringer, and also like Elspeth can gain some life with her minus ability if need be, or pump some the other lifelinkers. Lurrus also has lifelink as well. And you also have the Maul with Skyclaves, which can go around like here with lifelink, and like Speaker itself can carry the Maul and can do a lot of damage. Also, Seasoned Hollowblade into Maul is pretty powerful as well, just because it becomes a 4-turn clock on turn 3, and it's kind of hard to stop because this is indestructible and has first strike and flying. Hushbringer is obviously just a unique way to stop, like, rogues and other creatures that have annoying enter the battlefield abilities. I'm not usually a huge fan of aggro decks, but I decided to give this one a whirl just because it looks a little different. It's mono white, which has been like one of the worst colors in Magic recently. And he got second. They got second place. So I want to see how it does. Also, I've been playing Cube a lot too recently. Haven't really messed around too much with Historic. So been doing like that for the holidays. So don't have a quite new deck for y'all yet. I will have a new one for you on Friday. A Historic deck, hopefully. If not on Friday, I might do just a Cube draft instead. I might do a best of three cube draft and see how we do there for the video on Friday. I've been enjoying Cube a lot. It's been really fun. A lot of lands for a 22 land deck, but here we are. I'm not sure what the opponent's on. Okay. Next turn, Elspeth too, to pump them, make the clock a little faster. This art is so weird. Just a bunch of lips everywhere. Very, very strange art. Opt is a little annoying, but it's fine. So they make
death itself will help. Courage will bloom in all who seek justice.
If they don't like block here, probably should block. I can tap one down with the giant killer and pump the other two. Evolving Wilds. That's Poor Man's Passage. It's okay. We have trickle down economics. It's gonna trickle down. Draw four other cards. Definitely not exiling cards. If I draw another land, hopefully it's Castle Ardenvale. And they have no way to draw a card here. Never mind.
Steady your mind, Rowan.
And I will inspire your heart.
I enjoy the proper application of knowledge.
Opponent has a theme. I see it. What would do a land? Sadly, not the one I wanted.
You are braver than you know.
I'm just going to push in for as much damage as possible. Take five. I'll hold this land to, I don't know, bluff something. if they happen to have a Storm's Wrath, we probably just lose the game. Omnibus Seas. That is Waffles. So I got a doggy door. Waffles up there. Hopefully, Waffles doesn't use it to usually use restroom. He uses the doggy door to go outside and just bark at random things. Yeah. So is he barking at a cricket? Who knows? Could be a cricket. Or it could be the wind. Get them, Waffles! Take their soul. Fire Prophecy. Is this seven? Seven? Alright, if they can draw one more card, they can make an 8/8. If I can tap the 8/8 down. Also, I like pumping the tokens, because if they want to kill something, I'd rather be a token than an actual creature. Even if they can, like, so we have, like, lethal with one block. But if they can make a Kraken. Huh, well in that case, I'll tap that. Still should be lethal though. Nice. And that worked out pretty well. Thankfully, opponent didn't have like a Storm's Wrath or a Flame Sweep or anything to like really shake up the board there. There were a couple turns where a Storm's Wrath just like wrecks us. Okay, I like this. Like, we have the really good start of, like, Hollow Blade into Maul if we find the land for it. If we don't find a land, I can just play Hushbringer. Didn't find a land. We'll play this to keep these creatures small and from like draining. Wow, Banishing Light's like the only thing that can really hurt us there. If it was an actual removal spell, it would have been better. We're in a tough spot. Okay. By tough spot, I mean we're dead. Good. The removal they have is actually very, very good against Selfless Savior. Third clear. Alright, well, we're dead. We are super dead. Triple Cleric of Life's Bond. Maybe I can stabilize somehow. Probably by giving the Maul to Lurrus. This can attack. If I attack, making crack back for a lot. I'll just wait a little longer. Well, I can't wait anymore. Yeah, I'm just super dead. Have to tackle Thuris. Because they draw a cleric, I die. I'm still probably dead anyways, but... Clerics plus other stuff. Oof, oof. I'm just making it hard for them to attack. I guess on Luris. A speaker came down a little too late, thankfully. A weird game. Thought we were dead and we're somehow clawing back in. I'll block like this and give one of the dogs indestructible. Right.
You are brave.
I have to reduce them to lower life total. I don't want them to like go ham with the speaker. I think she can just die, it's fine. The dogs. Alright. This is... what a crazy game. This is just... both of us attacking back and forth. This thing he's making lifelink tokens. I have to kill it now. They give up. Had lethal unless I had the removal spell. I legit thought I was gonna lose that game in the beginning. I actually thought I legit thought we're dead, but Maul and Lifelink put us back in the game. I understand like their deck, the opponent's deck was like a not a tier deck, but it's still like, oh no. Going from like dead to 47 life and winning the game was pretty wild. Pretty wild. Sure. We're playing Yorion. Probably a slower deck. Little speaker here. Next turn I'll just Hollow Blade. I'm not sure if I want to Lurrus. or hold up protection. Honestly, I think I'll just go in. That's fine. Try to push in as much damage as I can. They need a shatter this guy. Unless they're playing red, but I doubt they're playing red. I'm just gonna play Lurrus. Go all in. And the best play would be Extinction Event, right? Or Cry of the Carnarium, but I don't think they're playing Cry of the Carnarium. That is not what you want. Not what you want. I want to see that. Opponent does not want to see that. Alright, that's the game. Unless they have darkness. Alright. We ended the Enders. I'm going all the way. All the way. This deck does seem pretty well positioned against the slow decks. Speaker. Alright, well. Kind of scared to play Hushbringer in case they're playing Kroxa. That's not good. I'm trying to go this out of deadweight range, at the very least. Okay. So they did have a second deadweight. I'm gonna hold in case they have like Myers Grasp. Because they draw Myers Grasp, rather. Okay, well, I can't attack anymore. No more attacking for me. If I have one more land, I can get Luris going too, which would be nice. Luris is just so protected in this deck. You have Alcide and Savior. Well, that is a good one. Wrinkle's pretty good. We can draw Maul the Skyclaves. Maul will be fantastic. We're doing everything. This is a weird game. They're trying to grind us with Rankle. We're kind of stabilizing with the other one. They cannot kick that. Come on, maul the Skyclaves. That is definitely not maul the Skyclaves. Rankle's getting out of hand. Come on, man. Easy to land there. I won this race. We have lifelink, they don't have lifelink. They can make us each sack, but like they're doing everything again. Sure. That's annoying. It's a lot of Lurrus. You need to maul this guy, Claves, please. Did you do another land for Skyclave Shade? What'd they draw? Skyclave Shade. Skyclave Shade. Going in. They're gonna keep attacking me like that. I'm gonna keep just going him with Rankle, then I'll just go crazy with Lifelink. Oh no, they drew Agadeen's Awakening. That is not good. Hateful Eidolon. Actually, no. If they do Awakening, we lose the game. Because they have the Vessel in the graveyard. They can just bring back the Vessel. The Demon. Actually, no, we don't lose. We're fine. We can just get Alcide, right? Okay, so we win. We win. I have to walk this. Otherwise they can just drain us with Wrinkle. That Wrinkle did a lot of work. I said Lurrus. Lurrus also just did a lot of work there. Got him. Protection from black. Can't be blocked. These creature games are actually pretty intense. Like, when we play against the control decks, I feel like it's, you know, it's pretty lopsided. But the creature decks are very a lot of like small decisions. Just making combat, outside combat. Let's get lifelink going. Mono red, no. Okay. Please attack. Okay. Hello? You know what? One red player. Makes sense. Stereotype checks out. I don't know. I don't even. Did they just think I couldn't, like. What? They think maybe they thought I couldn't discard a card? Maybe they thought it was only, like, on my turn I could discard a card? I don't know. I don't know what they thought. No. Well, you know what? GG's. GG's. Next game. That was, like, the fastest game of my life. That was so fast. I am high rolling today. I keep going first. And this is how you become a pro at MPG. Just go first. I want to protect the Hushbringer with Alcide. Whatever. It's fine. You take whatever you want. Bruh. Yeah, Hushbringer is like probably the best card against them, so. I'm okay with that. People just don't, I guess they don't care if they trade. really want to trade. I'm not sure. I should discard the Hushbringer to Season Hollowblade though. That was a mistake. Definitely a mistake on my part. No cards left my hand. That works. Nice. Nice. we're both Lurrus decks. Maybe the white one's favored against the black. I'm not sure, but maybe he's just very play draw dependent. Cruising along here. All right. Keep winning the the pro lottery. Who gets to go first? Oh no. It's the mirror match. Maybe not. Lord Princess can be blocked by creatures with power 3 or greater. Creatures with power 3, I see. Interesting. I guess let's go to the skies. Well, that's a beating. Is not good. If either playing that, I would have brought in. I would have played the Hushbringer. Did not know that. The more you know. This prince is gonna get a hand. Just don't think I can really race it.
Together we can exact justice.
I Probably should just equip them all here. Instead of playing a new one. Okay.
Do my best to support you.
So the plan here is just to save your and block the princess. Oh god. Oh man, that sucks. I just have to hope I've drawn another Lurrus or Alcide or Savior. Okay. Well, now they have too much lifelink. Now we lose. Even if I draw the Sky Clavis, it's not really good enough. I mean, I tried for as long as I could, but that princess, that aberration in the princess was too much for me. Especially with Sentinel Eyes. Kind of attack or block. Had to fly over it. And then the Banishing Light on the Lurrus when we couldn't sacrifice the dog to protect Lurrus. Play Giant Killer. If we're going to buff a creature up, I don't necessarily want to buff the Selfless Savior. Looks like. It's a rare match. Smork, 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 smork. I think they have to stop smorking though.
Alright.
Well, that's one way to stop smorking. Easy peasy. We had one loss, it was sent to the mirror. We did it! We did it, Reddit. Alright. Well, deck's pretty good, obviously. And it's not just autopilot. You do have to think a little bit, especially with Lurrus and sacking your Silver Savior and Alcide. What to buff, where the mall should go. Some lines are obviously, like, sometimes you just get lucky and, you know, you go first every game and you have one drop, two drop, three drop, and you just win the game, but some of us, not all of us can do that. But this deck was pretty cool. I did like all the little synergies you could do, interactions you could do with in combat. I'm not really used to that, so that was kind of fun. But we did get 7 wins, which means we're going to flex. Sweet, sweet. But everyone, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Make sure to follow me on twitter.com/AllYoDrazi and twitch.tv/AllYoDrazi. Also, if you shop at coolstuffinc.com, make sure you use code Ollie5 to get 5% off your entire order and get a sweet Ollie token. Again, this is Max Capone's. So I appreciate it. Thank you for the sweet list. All right, everyone, have a wonderful day or night, wherever you are. And I'll see you back on Friday for Best of 3. All right, take it easy.